Good morning everyone, welcome to MSc the online class day. So up to this, whatever we have studied about division of polynomial, we get a clear idea that whenever a number is completely divided by another number, then the remainder will be zero. Let us take an example to understand this concept. Suppose a number 10, okay, is divided by 5, okay, then what will be the remainder? 5 to 10. And the remainder will be 0. So here we see the remainder is 0. That means we can say 5 completely divides 10. Tala ame koi parira nahi ki 5 ta 10 ko completely divide karuchi. So we can say 5 completely divides 10 or 10 is completely divided by 5. There is a difference between divided and completely divided. Okay. So if it completely divides a number, then the remainder will be 0. Okay, so 5 completely divides 10. Clear? And remainder will be how much? 0. This is also clear. And see one more thing. Find the factor of 10. The factor of 10 is 1, 2, 5, and 10. Let me show you here. See, 5 is also a factor of 10, and here 5 is a divisor of 10. Okay, that means you can say 5 is also a factor of 10, and that 5 completely divides 10. Okay, that means we can say if a number is a factor of other number, then it completely divides the other number. Okay, and if it completely divides the other number, then the remainder will be 0. There is two concepts. First one is combined concept. First one is if a number is a factor of other number. Okay, if a number is factor of other number. Here 5 is the factor of 10. This is the first concept. Then what will happen? Then it completely divides 10. Okay, this is the first concept. If 5 is a factor of 10, then 5 completely divides 10. Clear? And the second concept is, if it completely divides 10, then the remainder will be 0. Clear? You can take one more example. Suppose, you can say 20. Okay. Now we will find the factor of 20. 1, 2, 4, 5, 10 and 20. Okay. So, let us find a number among the factor. Okay. Suppose I am choosing 10. Okay, I am choosing 10. Then what we will do? We have to divide 20 by its own factor. Okay, 10 is a factor of 20. We have already known it. So, let us divide. 22 is a 10, 20 into the 20. Okay, so the remainder is 0. So, here we get if 10 is a factor of 20, then it completely divides the dividend, and if it completely divides the dividend, then the remainder will be 0. Are you clear? Okay, here 10 is a factor of 20, and 10 also divides 20 completely because the remainder is 0. Okay, so this is the first concept. Now coming to one more example, suppose we have written 21 here. So find the factor of 21. 1, 3, 7 and 21. Let us divide 21 by 5. You see, 5 is not a factor of 21, but 5 divides 21. Then what will be the result or what will be the remainder? 5 for the 20 and the remainder is 1. So we see if we will take a number which is not a factor of other number but divided by with the same number, then the remainder is not 0. The remainder is not 0 means 5 doesn't completely divide 21. Okay, if the remainder will be 0, then we can say yes, 5 divides 21 completely. But here we didn't get 0 as a remainder, so we can say 5 doesn't completely divide 21. Okay, so final conclusion is that if a number is not a factor of other number, and if that number is divided by the first number, then the remainder is not zero. Okay, that means if a number is not a factor of other number, then it doesn't completely divide the number and the remainder doesn't equal to zero. Okay, this is the concept you must remember. The remainder theorem that we have already studied states the same thing. It states that if P of X be the dividend, if P of X be the dividend, okay, whose degree is equal to 1 or greater than 1, okay, it is the dividend, is divided by a factor X minus 1, it is divided by, so it is divided, see here, here it is written divided, it doesn't write as completely divided, it only written divided. So we cannot say whether x minus a is a real factor or not of P of X. Okay, so whenever a dividend P of X is divided by a divisor or factor x minus a, then the remainder will be P of A, then the remainder is P of A. Okay, but suppose you think, suppose here we will get remainder 0, then what we can say? We can say x minus a completely divide P of X. Okay, and we can say x minus is a real factor of P of X. Okay, but here we didn't get 0, here we get remainder as P of A. It means x minus a does not completely divide P of X, it divides partially. Mane kichhi kichhi divide koruchi, jemti ka you can take 21 divided by 5, it means 5 does not completely divide 21, but it partially divide 21. Clear? So here also x minus a is not a factor of P of X. Why? Because we didn't get 0 in the remainder, that means it doesn't completely divide P of X and it is not a factor of P of X. Okay, this is the remainder theorem states about. So from the theories that we are discussing recently, a new theorem is arised and its name is factor theorem. So the name of the new theorem is factor theorem. It is derived from the concepts that we are discussing earlier. So what does the factor theorem states? It has two statements, statement 1 and statement 2. So let us define what does the statement 1 says. The statement 1 says, if P of X be a polynomial of degree greater than or equal to 1. So what does it say? It says if P of X, okay, be a polynomial and whose degree is greater than or equal to 1. That means here we take the P of X as a dividend. Okay? Okay, it is divided. Divided means this. Okay, it is divided completely by a factor. Okay, it is divided completely by factor x minus a. That means P of X is divided by x minus a. And x minus a is a factor of P of X. Okay, and x minus a is a factor of P of X. And x minus a completely divide. See, divided completely. And x minus a completely divide P of X. Then the remainder P of X is equal to 0. That means then the remainder will be 0. Okay. You can compare this question with another question as we had. Suppose 10 is a number. Write down its factor. Okay. And that 10 is again divided by 2. Okay. See. Is it 2 is a factor of 10? Yes, 2 is a factor of 10 and that 2 also divides the 10. As we know, if any number is a factor of other number, then it completely divides the other number. That means 2 completely divides the other number and the remainder will be 0. Here also same thing happened. You can compare these two problems. So that means if p of x, that polynomial of degree greater than or equal to 1, is divided by a factor x minus a, okay, then x minus a completely divides p of x. As we know, if a number completely divides other number, then the remainder will be 0. In this case, since 2 is a factor of 10, and 2 also completely divides 10, because 2 5 is 10, then we get the remainder will be 0. Okay, so this is the first statement that says, okay, so this is the first statement. Then coming to the next one, what does the next statement state? It states that if remainder p of a is equal to 0, then it says, suppose p of x is a polynomial, okay, you can take a number for this, suppose 30 be a number, okay, then x minus a is a factor, means it is divided by a factor x minus a, okay, then suppose the remainder is 0, that means suppose it is divided by 5, and after division suppose the remainder is 0, okay, then we can say according to the statement 2, if 0 is the remainder of the division, then 5 is the factor of 30. Is it true or false? Jodi 0 ta ko ame dhariba remainder, tale 5 ta tara gote factor hobo. Is it true or false? We can check out whether it is true or false. What are the factor of 30? 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 10, 15, and 30. Okay, out of the factor of 30, does the factor contain 5? Yes, the factor contains 5. Okay, so we can say if the remainder is 0, okay, then 5 is a factor of 30. Okay, similarly, if the remainder is 0, then we can say x minus a is the factor of p of x. So we can say x minus a is a factor of p of x. And in this case, we can say 5 is a factor of 30. These two problems are quite similar. Okay, you can now compare the statement 1 and statement 2. Let us compare. In statement 1, we have if p of x is a polynomial, okay, and x minus a is its factor, then x minus a completely divides p of x, so that the remainder will be 0. Okay, but the second statement says that if remainder will be 0, then x minus is a factor of p of x. That means the statement 1 and the statement 2 are converse, okay, are complementary to each other. Tamane eta jodi sidha hoche seta hoche tara ulta. Clear? It says that p of x jodi polynomial hobe, then x minus is its factor and it divides completely the p of x, so that remainder will be 0. And the second statement says if remainder 0, then x minus is a factor. So both are complementary to each other, both are opposite to each other. Okay, these are the two statements says that. Okay, you can take an example to clarify your doubt. Suppose we have a polynomial p of x is 2x plus 4. Okay, suppose we have a question, this is divided by x plus 2. Okay, find remainder. This is a question for you. If find remainder if p of x is equal to 2x plus 4 is divided by x plus 2. So here we have to find remainder. And what we have? We have p of x is equal to dividend. Okay? And it is equal to 2x plus 4. And what we have? We have g of x, that is divisor, okay, is equal to x plus 2. So we have to find out the value of the remainder. Since it is a question from remainder theorem that we have already discussed in the previous session, how we can find out the remainder? if the dividend and the divisor is given without actually dividing, we can find out the value of the remainder. How? By simply converting the divisor in the form x minus a. As we know, we have to convert the divisor in the form x minus a. How? We can make x plus 2 as x minus minus 2. Okay? Because minus minus is plus. So we can write x plus 2 as x minus of minus 2. So here, now compare this two polynomial. This is and this is. Here x, here x, here minus, here minus, here a, here minus 2. So we can write a is equal to minus 2. So in this way, we can find out the value of a. You can use other method to find the value of a or x. How we can find? By simply putting the divisor to 0. Okay, by simply putting the divisor to 0, you can also find the value of a or x. Okay, so here x is equal to how much? Minus 2. X is nothing but a. Both are equal. What is a and what is x are both equal. Okay, so in this method we will get x or a is equal to minus 2. Here also we get the value of x is minus 2. Now we are going to find the value of the remainder. As we know, we have p of x is equal to 2x plus 4. Okay, but according to the remainder theorem, it will be p of a. So it will be how much? 2a plus 4. So in the place of a, you will put minus 2. So the next result will be 2 into minus 2 is minus 4 plus 4 implies p of minus 2 is equal to 0. So what is the value of remainder? We get the value of the remainder is 0. Okay. So finally we can get the conclusion that if the remainder is 0, it is compared with the second statement of the factor theorem. See, here also if the remainder is 0, here also we have if the remainder is 0, then x minus a is a factor of p of x. So here also if the remainder is 0, can we say x plus 2 is a factor of 2x plus 4? Yes. If p of a is equal to 0, that means here if 2x plus 4 is the dividend, is divided by x plus 2, and finally we get the remainder as 0, then I can say yes, x plus 2 is a factor of 2x plus 4. Clear? This is the second statement. You can understand easily by dividing 2x plus 4 with x plus 2, and we will get here the remainder is 0. Clear? These are the statements regarding factor theorem. So let us understand how the factor theorem works. So for this we have a question here. Examine whether x plus 2 is a factor of x cube plus 3x square plus 5x plus 6. So what we have here? We have p of x. P of x means dividend. Okay. So the dividend is x cube plus 3x square plus 5x plus 6, and the other thing is g of x. Here the g of x means divisor. Okay, so divisor is equal to x plus 2. So we have to examine. Examine means we have to verify. Okay, we have to verify or we have to check so that x plus 2 is a factor of this or it is not a factor of this polynomial. We have to verify it. For example, we can take, suppose 6 is a number, okay, and it is divided by 3. Okay, now compare this problem with the problem given in the board. Here we have to prove whether 3 is a factor of 6 or not. We have to examine it. Similarly, here we have to examine whether x plus 2 is a factor of x cube plus 3x square plus 5x plus 6 or not. Okay, so as from the factor theorem statement 2, we know if the remainder becomes 0, then we can say that the other number is a factor, other polynomial is a factor of the dividend. That means in the statement 2 we have learned, suppose let us divide it, 3 to the 6, this is 0. So here the remainder is 0 and the remainder is known as P of A. Yes or no? Yes. So the statement 2 states that if the remainder is 0, then we can say 3 is a factor of 6. And if the remainder is not 0, then it is not a factor. So the quite simple thing is, we have to first find out whether in this case the remainder is 0 or not. Suppose the remainder will be 0, then we can say yes, it is a factor of this polynomial. But if we find the remainder P of A not equal to 0, then can we say it is a factor? No, it is not a factor. For example, if 8 is divided by 5, okay, so 5 comes up 5 and the remainder is 3. So here we have the remainder 3. So can we say 5 is a factor of 8? No, we can't say 5 is a factor of 8 because the remainder is not 0 here. So the first task is to find out the remainder and judge and verify whether the remainder is 0 or not. So let us find the remainder first. Okay. So finding the remainder is also quite easy, because in the remainder theorem part we have studied how to find a remainder if the divisor is given and dividend is given. Okay. Since we have the divisor is x plus 2. So here we have to first find out the value of A. A means x, and x means it is also known as 0 of the polynomial. Yes or no? 0 of this polynomial. Here we have to find out the value of A or x, or you can say 0, or you can say root. These all things are similar. They bear the same meaning. Okay. So first we have to find out the value of A here, or 0 of the polynomial here. How can we find out the value of x? By simply putting the divisor to 0. Okay. Then we can get x is equal to minus 2. Okay. So here we get x is equal to minus 2. This is also known as 0, or this is also known as root of the polynomial, or this is also known as A. Whatever you can say to it. Okay. Now, the second task is to find out the remainder of the polynomial. As we have P of x is equal to x cube plus 3x square plus 5x plus 6. Since we are going to find the remainder, remainder means P of A. Here we have A or x is equal to minus 2. So in the place of x or A, you will put minus 2. So let us find out the value of the polynomial by putting minus 2 on x or in the place of x. So the polynomial will be minus 2 to the power 3 plus 3 whole into minus 2 to the power 2 plus 5 whole into minus 2 plus 6. Clear? So minus 2 to the power 3. Okay. So minus 2 is multiplied 3 times. When a negative number is multiplied odd number of times, then the result will be minus. So it will be minus 8. Again, plus 3 into minus 2 to the power 2 means minus minus plus 2 square is 4. 5 into 2 is minus, minus 2 is minus 10. Then plus 6 is equal to minus 8 plus 3 4 is 12 plus minus minus 10. Okay, plus 6. Now, first add them. Minus 8 plus 12 will be 4, because different sign, since they will be subtracted. Then minus 10 plus 6. 4 minus 10 is minus 6, then plus 6. And minus 6 plus 6 is 0. Hence what we get? We get the value of the remainder, or you can say P of A, is equal to 0. This is the final result we are getting here. So as we know, according to the statement 2 of the factor theorem, if the remainder is 0, okay, then we can say, or if P of A is 0, then we can say x minus A is a factor. This is the statement 2.
Yes or no?
Yes. So here we can say since the remainder is 0, then we can say yes, x plus 2 is a factor of x cube plus 3x square plus 5x plus 6. Okay? So it is verified. So we can say yes, x plus 2 is a factor of x cube plus 3x square plus 5x plus 6. This is verified. Okay. Suppose in this case we didn't get 0 in the remainder. So we can say the x plus 2 is not a factor of x cube plus 3x square plus 5x plus 6. Okay. Since we are getting 0 in the remainder, then we can say yes, x plus 2 is a factor. Clear? So coming to the next question, it is also a similar type of question as question number 1 we have done. So the question 2 we have, examine whether x minus 1 is a factor of 4x cube plus 3x square minus 4x minus 2. So we have to verify it or examine it. So first write down what we have. We have here p of x, that is the dividend. It's 4x cube plus 3x square minus 4x minus 2. This is the dividend. And what we have? We have also g of x, that is the divisor. Okay. So here we have to verify or check whether this polynomial or this divisor is a factor of this polynomial or not. As we know from the statement 2 of the factor theorem, if we can show p of a, that is the remainder, to be 0, then we can say yes, x minus 1 is a factor. But if we don't show p of a is to be 0, then we can say yes, it is not a factor. So our first task is to find out the value of the remainder in this case. Okay. So for this, we first need the value of a, or you can say x, or you can say root. Okay. Or you can say 0. So these 4 are same. Okay. So you have to find the value of x here. Okay. So or 0 of the polynomial here. For this, we have to put the divisor to be 0. Then we get x is equal to 1. Hence, we get the root is x is equal to 1. This is known as the root or 0 or a or x. Now we have to find out the remainder. Since we have p of x is equal to 4x cube plus 3x square minus 4x minus 2. So we need to find the value of the remainder. So remainder is p of a, or p of a is 1. Then substitute the place in the place of x, 1. So we have plus 3, 1 square minus 4 into 1 minus 2 is equal to 4 into 1 cube is 1, plus 3 into 1 square is 1, minus 4 into 1 is 4 minus 2, 4 into 1 is 4, 3 into 1 is 3 minus 4 minus 2, 4 plus 3 is 7 minus 4 minus 2, 4 minus 4 is, or 7 minus 4 is 3 minus 2, and 3 minus 2 is 1. So what we get here? We get the remainder, or you can say p of a, a means p of 1 is how much? 1. So here we get the remainder is not equal to 0. If it will be 0, then we can say yes, x minus 1 is a factor. But here we get the remainder is not equal to 0. That means x minus 1 is not a factor. Okay. So we can write, hence x minus 1 is not a factor. Why? Because we did not get 0 in the remainder. Okay, if we will get 0 in the remainder, then we can say yes, it is a factor. Since we are not getting, that's why it is not a factor. Now coming to the question number 3. In question number 3, what we have? We have also to examine whether 2x plus 1 is a factor of this polynomial. So write down what we have. We have p of x is equal to x square plus x by 2. And we have g of x is equal to 2x plus 1. So we have to, or we need to find the value of the remainder here. So for this, we need to find the value of a or x or root. So for this, we have to equate the divisor to be 0, and we get 2x is equal to minus 1 implies x is equal to minus 1 by 2 here. So this is the value of the root of 0 or a. Now we have to find the value of the remainder. As we have p of x is equal to x square plus x by 2. Okay. So in the place of x, we need to put minus 1 by 2. Why? Because this is the formula for remainder. This is the remainder part. So substitute minus half in the place of x. So minus half square plus. In the place of x, put minus half divided by 2. Okay. Look at carefully. Minus is multiplied twice. It will be plus. And 1 by 2 square is 1 square is 1, 2 square is 4. Okay, this is clear. Then plus. Okay, curly bracket start. What we have seen? This is the numerator part. Think this is a division. This is the numerator part. This is the denominator part. Think as it is. So we can write minus half. So for this division, can we write divide 2? Yes, we can write, because this is the division and this is known as divided by. That means for that we can write a division symbol. Okay. So the part we have, 1 by 4 plus minus 1 by 2. When division convert into multiplication, then this part will be interchange, or you can write its reciprocal. Clear? So 1 by 4 plus 1 1 jar 1, 2 2 jar 4. So it will be 1 by 4 plus minus minus 1 by 4. Okay? Then you get 4 4 is the same as 4. 1 minus 1 is equal to 0 by 4 is equal to 0. See, finally you get the remainder to be 0. So you can write P of A means minus half is equal to 0. So according to the statement 2 of the factor theorem, as we know, if the remainder is 0, then we can say this one is a factor of the dividend. So here also we get the remainder will be 0. Hence we can say yes, 2x plus 1 is a factor of x square plus x plus 2. So in all the cases we need to find the value of the remainder, then we can verify whether something or some polynomial is a factor of the dividend or it is not a factor. This is clear? Okay. So let me show you some different type of question. And we have here, if p of minus 1 is equal to 0, then find the factor. So what we have? We have p of minus 1 is equal to 0. This means p of something. Suppose we can say this p of a is equal to 0. P of something means it is the remainder. It is nothing but the remainder. So according to the question, what we have given? We have given the remainder is equal to 0. This is clear. Here given remainder is 0. And what we need to find? We need to find the value of the factor here. Okay. This is a question which is converse to the question 1, 2 and 3 that we have done. Okay. How? See. According to the statement 2 of the factor theorem, it says us, or it tells us, the statement 2 of the factor theorem, if P of A is equal to 0, P of A means if remainder. Okay. It says if remainder is 0, then x minus a is a factor of the polynomial P of x. Okay. This is the second statement of factor theorem says that. So it says that if P of A is equal to 0, okay, then x minus a is 0, its factor. Here also see one thing. Here also we have P of A is equal to 0. That means here also remainder is 0. And here also remainder is 0. And it tells us if remainder is 0, then x minus is a factor. Here also, if the remainder is 0, then we can say, what we can say? Hence, factor is x minus a, because this is the statement 2. Clear? So we need to find the value of factor and we also find it. But here we have x. X is the variable. But we do not know the value of a here. Okay. So our task is to find the value of a so that we can easily find the factor. by putting the value of a in the polynomial. Okay, so here we need to find the value of a here. Okay, so how can we find the value of a? Look at here part we have. We have here p of minus 1 is equal to 0. This is the remainder part. Okay, now remainder part means the remainder can be written as p of a, or p of a is equal to 0. Okay, so compare this two equation. Here p, this means it is also a remainder, it is also a remainder. The remainder is 0, the remainder is 0. But in the place of a, what we have? We have minus 1. That means a is equal to minus 1. Okay, so in the question, we have also the value of a. And we know the value of a here. So the value of a is minus 1. This is clear? Now coming to the factor. As we have already written that the factor is x minus x. So in the place of a, we have to put the value of a. How? By x. In the place of x, I am writing x. In the place of minus, I am writing minus. And in the place of a, I am writing minus 1. Because the value of a is minus 1. Okay. So the factor is, it becomes x minus minus plus 1. Hence, this is done. Hence, our factor is x plus 1. Okay, are you getting my point? So first, we need to find the value of a, as it has already given in the question that p of a is equal to 0. And here a is minus 1. As we know, if the remainder is 0, then the factor is x minus a. Then the factor is minus a. Since we know the value of a is minus 1, by putting the value of a as minus 1, we get the factor is x plus 1. Okay. So in this way, you can find the factor if the remainder is given. But one thing here you know. Since here we get a is equal to minus 1. A is also known as the root of the equation. Na? Or a is known as the x. Or a is known as the 0. Yes or no? Yes, that means we have a. A means it is the root of the polynomial. In some cases, you have a question, if root is 2, then find the value of the factor. Okay, the question may be like this. If the root is 2, okay, then find the factor. Here 2 means root, and root is nothing but a, you know. Root is nothing but a. So here a is equal to 2. And then what is the factor? As we know, the factor is always written in the form x minus a. According to the second statement of factor theorem. So the factor is x minus, in the place of a, you can write 2. So x minus 2 is a factor. In some cases, you have a question like, if the root is minus 3, find the factor. How can you find the factor? As we know, minus 3 is the root. That means a is equal to minus 3, because a is also known as the root of the polynomial or divisor. Now, as we know, the factor is always written in the form x minus a. Okay? So, x minus, in the place of a, you can write minus 3. So, x minus minus plus, it will be plus 3. Hence, the factor is x plus 3. Okay? This is the second type of question. And if we have a question, if root is minus root 2, okay, find the factor. How we can find if root is minus root 2? Okay. So, what we have here? We have root. Root means we know the value of a. And as we know, the factor is written in the form x minus a. That means x minus a is minus root 2. So, we can write it is as x plus root 2. So this is our factor. So clear now? Okay, let us do some more problem here. As in the question 5, we have p of 7 is equal to 0. So we have p of 7 means this is the remainder, because the remainder is written in the form p of x. So here we have p of 7 is equal to 0. Since the remainder is written in the form p of a is equal to 0. Hence, can we say a is equal to 7 here? Yes, a is equal to 7 here. Or we can say the root is 7. Okay, so here we get the root is 7. Now what we will going to find? We are going to find the factor. Okay, so as we know from the statement 2 of factor theorem, if p of a is equal to 0, then the factor is defined in the form x minus a. Okay, a is the root, and as we know the value of a, we can put in the place of a 7. This is the answer that we are going to find. Hence we can write the factor of polynomial is x minus 7. This is the factor. Okay, so in this way you can find out if root is given or the remainder is 0. Okay, coming to the question number 6, and in question number 6 we have p of minus 2. That means the remainder is p of minus 1 by 2 is equal to 0. That means we know the value of a or root. Hence we can write root is equal to a is equal to how much here? This is minus half. Why? Because the remainder can be written in the form p of a. Okay, so p and p are here in the place of a. Here it is written minus half or minus 1 by 2. So we can write, hence root is minus 1 by 2. Okay, and again, as you know, if the remainder is 0, then the factor will be written in the form x minus a. Okay, hence now put the value of a in this polynomial. So a is minus 1 by 2. So x minus minus plus x plus half. Finally, we get the value of the factor. Hence, we can write the factor is x plus 1 by 2. And this factor is nothing but the divisor of the dividend. Okay. So using factor theorem, you can find out whether a polynomial is a factor or not, and you also can find out if the remainder is 0, then the factor is x minus a. These are the various applications of factor theorem. Clear?